It is not surprising, although certainly quite disappointing. The image you just saw before our intro came from an interview with CBR and Todd McFarlane. That piece of shite comic books news website, and I'm using the term news here with major air quotes, is known to be ultra mega woke, filled with idiotic takes to further the permeating agenda in Hollywood and bent on labeling the fandom as toxic in any way possible, which is why I think McFarlane answered the way he did. That doesn't make it right either. In my book, you should stick to your guts and principles and should always defend them. And we can give him the benefit of the doubt, maybe, considering that Spawn is one of the few comic books out there that hasn't succumbed to the woke idiocy that has taken the industry hostage. And in the toys department, the quality hasn't waned and the woke is not really perceived. In fact, the most recently announced comic book, that is the Gunslinger Spawn, is the best introduction of a character since 2015's Spider-Win, with a reported 300,000 shipping order, and it's beating actually Spider-Win in that department. Anyway, McFarlane talked about the upcoming Spawn film, and amongst other things, he commented the film wasn't going to be an origin story and that as a Canadian white guy, he doesn't really know what it is like to live as a black man in America. Funny, you know, that didn't stop him from creating Spawn's alter ego as Al Simmons, who is a black American soldier of sorts, back in 1994, when the character first debuted. Now, all of a sudden, he's unfit to tell the story of a black character because he's a white guy from Canada. Get out of here! This is utterly ridiculous. Why don't you stop publishing the comic altogether then, you know? Or better yet, terminate your toy company because it has the likeness of your character, who is black, and it can be construed as colonization on your part because you've become stupid rich out of that black character. Colonizer much? Then cancel it. For a guy who wants to virtue signal this time, it does look like he has made tons of money out of a character he can't even properly write because he isn't black and he isn't even American, according to his logics, of course. Because in reality, there's nothing absolutely wrong with writing a character that's different from your ethnicity or even your nationality. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that. This is a joke from whichever angle you want to look at it, and it is truly hilarious, and also it is a disappointment, as I just said at the beginning. We are talking about a man who made his fortune and built a company by thinking out of the box. A man who wasn't content with just getting crumbs from the industry and decided to gather a group of friends of like mind to build something that challenged the industry as it was known back in the day. Unfortunately, that man seems to be gone now. This McFarlane seems to be bending the knee to the woke idiots in Hollywood to get his movie done, isn't the same McFarlane who got out of Marvel despite being one of the hot artists there and built Image Comics to be the owner of his own work. This McFarlane so craving to add social issues and current politics that are plaguing the world isn't the same bold McFarlane we knew and who would have just found a way of making the movie he wanted, bypassing the Hollywood executives who never understand what things are really about. This tells me that this is the sort of film McFarlane wants to make, and as I said, perhaps you can say that this is all something that he told CBR in order to save face with them, and that the movie isn't really going to be that woke, and that it doesn't matter to him if a black guy is writing the film right now, or if a white guy writes it later on, or rewrites it, or whatever. But truth be told, the fact that he's just bending the knee, when before that, the McFarlane we knew and that we admired would have done exactly the opposite, well, that speaks volumes in this particular case. Now, In 1997, we had a spawn film by Nulla in cinema, and sure, it wasn't the best film ever. With all that unnecessary humor from John Leguizamo's Violator, and with the cape in all CGI, while the rest of the props and special effects suffered alongside with the story. Yeah, that's true. The problem with that film is that it's a product of its time, and with that, it also feels outdated a little bit. It can be seen as a curiosity, sure, but it isn't a cult classic or even a good movie by any stretch of the imagination. Now, you can like it, of course, but that doesn't make it a good film. And if you paid attention to what I just said, the key word here was time. By adding social commentary and current situations in a movie, it becomes a product of its time, and it won't stand the test that time gives to all of us. In some years, the movie will feel outdated and corny, stupid and without meaning. Instead, what filmmakers should strive to do is tell timeless stories. Even when a period piece is created, it resonates with us because of the themes it deals with. Nobody would say that The Lord of the Rings is outdated, or that Star Wars original trilogy is outdated. And the same can be said about other classics such as Back to the Future, or even The Karate Kid. And Back to the Future has the added singularity that it depicted a future in 2015 that we are not only not experiencing, and we are talking about 6 years after the fact, but far from actually making a reality. I mean, just look around. Those films are timeless because they talk about heroic feats, about feelings and emotions we all can relate to, and about personality traits that we either aspire to have or we can also relate to once again. But when a studio, or in this case a creator, makes the decision of making the identifying element that of social commentary of the current times or the politics of the day become center stage, then we have a problem of aging, and the film won't age any well at all. And if you add to that the fact that he is now throwing himself under the bus by stating that he is no black guy, so he wouldn't even know what a black guy experiences in America as life after close to 30 years of having this character around and created originally as a black character, it's just funny, stupid, and completely out of line, and something that, if you ask me, McFarlane shouldn't have said, even if he was having an interview with the wokest of the sites out there that used to be comic book sites not so long ago. If that was going to be the case, had I been McFarlane, I would have just said, you know what, I do not feel up to having an interview with you guys, I won't have it. That's my opinion, of course. As for me, I have no interest in watching this film if it ever gets made in the first place. I won't be buying any more Spawn books for the foreseeable future. I also feel like I won't be interested in whatever McFarlane Toys puts out there for now. And, you know, in a single phrase, I just don't support woke. And if McFarlane is going to go that route, then he can count with no money from my part, and my wallet will be closed. I am not doing this to break him. I am not doing this to drive him out of business. This is just my statement. And as always, this is only my opinion. So let me know down below in the comments yours, and whether you want to watch this film or will continue supporting McFarlane after these remarks from the CVR interview, or what your plans are, what you are thinking in this particular case. Until next time, everyone, peace out.